Okay, we're at a point now to get the stuff out of the box, and let me show you what comes in the box. You have a battery charger. These are what's going to go cover over the hubs. I'll just show this. If you come down here, you go over the front and the back. So just real quick, that's what they are for. You do get some tools. They like to call it a tool kit. And you can use this stuff to install it. I like to use our own metric. So you do get the tools to install it. It's not as nice as a regular set, but they do come. And they are helpful. You get a tire gauge. Now, you get a couple bags of bolts. These bags or bolts are going to be used to install the top bars. Okay, that's what they are. Okay? Then, you get a bag of bolts that has one, two, three, and then three nuts. That's going to install your tire. Your steering wheel. One, two, three. And then this piece will go over this like that. So I just want to show you, this was not in the box, but I wanted to show you what this is. This came, we unpackaged that later. So we set it over here with some other stuff. This bag here, we used for installing the dash. That's what these are all for, is to install the dash, and we'll get to that there. You got your couple long nuts and shorts and stuff like that. We also have our battery. Inside the battery is the battery acid. Of course, the charger will charge the battery. Once we put battery acid in, we're going to want to charge the battery for 6 hours with this here, and roughly 6 hours. This is a battery strap that will hold down the battery that goes over here, right over there. If you can come over there further, that square thing there, okay? This is your user's manual. There is some good information in the user manual. And this is their DVD that has information on there. We wanted to create our own video to give you another perspective, more of an American perspective. One thing I want to share here real quick is before you start that engine, make sure you drain and change your shipping oil. We'll get to that later. Do not start the unit with the shipping oil. Let's look at this here real quick. This is your dipstick. We'll be showing you this a little later. This is where you put oil in. So this is your dipstick. And it'll take between 3/4 to a quart of oil. And you are going, there is shipping oil in it already. You're going to fill that up to that top part of that line. If we come underneath here, let me put this back here. If you come underneath here, you're going to have to get underneath here. This is your drain plug right here. Right there is your drain plug right there. So we'll get to that a little later. Okay, next thing we want to do is install the intake and the carburetor. We're going to remove these two bolts here. If you look real close, there is a piece of clear tape we're going to want to remove completely. And here I want to remove that tape gently because we don't want to get anything in the carburetor into the engine. So we're just going to get over here, get underneath it, pull that back. So if you can see it kind of going a little bit around, so you get it all completely off. Oops, there's a little piece here that didn't come, so you want to make sure all that's off, and it is. Next step is to install the air cleaner in the carburetor, so we're going to cut that zip tie. We're going to remove gently. We don't want to break the intake. This here is your choke. And we'll get to that. This is your air cleaner. So what we're going to do is, this is your throttle cable, and we're going, and this is this goes right here, but first of all we got to get this installed. That's why this moves. So make sure when you put this on, you have a gasket. It should be glued at the factory. If it's not, it will not run. If you put this on without the gasket, it will not run. Because what happens is too much air gets into it, And with too much air, it's not the right gas fuel air mixture. Okay, so I'm going to tighten these down. Just a few things I want to point out while we're at the carburetor. This here is your, where I put the gas. This is your gas line. This is your idling. Your idling screw, and we'll talk about more of that later. But while we're here, you really can get a close look. This is your choked, you know, and we'll talk about that here shortly. This is your throttle also. So we're going to get these tightened down here. I'm going to need a wrench actually to do that. And then this goes back here once we tighten this down. So you just tighten them down nice and snug. Don't tighten one side and then the other. Run one side down and then go to the other. Nice. Tight, but not overly tight. Now I'm going back here. Tighten that one. I'm checking this again. Okay. And then we're going. Sometimes you may have to put a little lubricant to get in it, but that one went right in. So this is how you install the intake carburetor air cleaner. Now, this here is your choke. When it's up, that's choking the unit. When it's down, it's not choking. And we'll show that when we do a startup video. Okay, next step that we're going to do is we're going to install the dash. This, by the way, is your key and your remote off and on, and we'll talk about that more later. This is the bag with your dash stuff. You're going to need an Allen wrench and a number 10 metric wrench or socket set. I'm going to use a wrench. They have a little diagram there, so I'm just going to pull this out here. You have your spacers and then your big ones. So what we're going to do here, we're going to first install these. Pretty simple here. We're going to get started here. This is your spacer. This is threaded already in. We'll just get it started. We're not going to tighten it down. We got it started. Now we're going to go do the other side. The reason they do this is we find if this is not installed during shipping, we have less problems of things breaking. This dash. Okay, we got that started. So now we're going to go back here, and these little ones, this is where the number 10 is going to need to be used. That's why you don't want to tighten anything down first. Okay, this one. Even if it's too tight for what we have to do. It's not tight, it's just we need a little bit more play. Sometimes it takes a little bit to get these installed. Kurt, if you could just grab that and put it in the hole while I put it there. There you go. So sometimes, as you can see, many hands make light work. So now we're going to put these nuts on the back here. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, just like before, I'll get these all tightened down. get this one started. This one has the threads already on, tapped on the bottom. Over here, kind of do the fronts equally. That's what we do. Let's just show some features of dash here quick. This will show you forward, neutral, and reverse. This is your horn, your lights, your hazards lights. This is what turns on the light. You got low, high beam, and then your blinkers, and then your ignition. Okay, next thing we're going to do is install steering wheel. This is the bag with the three steering wheel nuts, bolts and nuts. This is your steering wheel, obviously, and we got our three. These are 10 millimeters, so 10 millimeter socket set and a 10 millimeter wrench. So we're going to pour these out here. Started. I'm not going to tighten them right away. I want to just snug everything first. Okay, so now we're going to tighten. They're just small number 10 bolts, so you don't have to go too crazy. Get them nice and tight, but not overly tight to snap off the bolts or pull the thread. Okay, that's how you install the steering wheel. Okay, first of all, we're going to install the seats. You can see that the nuts are right here. Also, this is how this shifting mechanism works. I'll show you here why we have it up. See, when you pull this up, and it allows this to, you know, move back and forth. It has quite the long distance. So when you install it, though, you kind of want the two to be about the same. That works better. And if you take a little grease or silicone, that really will make them slide even better. You can do that too. This one slides real good. Not all of them are greased as well or lubricated at the factory. Here's your seat belts. What we're going to do, first of all, is we do not want to install this with the seat belts underneath it. We're going to put the seat belts back here all of the way, just all of the way. Again, this is your remote. This here, why we have this off, this is when you shut it off here or turn it back on, this sends a signal here. This is your brains of it. This is the alarm, and we'll demonstrate that later. But with this off, you might as well take a really good look at it. We're going to remove the plastic here. On the bottom, just so we can get this off. Okay. So we're going to take these nuts off. These are 13. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set them away, a little bit away. And then these go right here. Make sure when we install it, we don't pinch any wires or anything like that. You see this here? We run all these cables on the inside of this. So this is how we do this. We put the cables on the inside. This goes on the outside. Then we put on the seat. So we'll start over here again, because we don't want too much binding on those cables. And then when we put the cables in, you want the cables to be on this side of these screws. And again, we do not want to pinch anything. A little bit to do it, but we did it correctly with the cables and the seat belt. So we're going to put these on and we're going to get them tightened. So I'm going to tighten up the other two and then we'll proceed forward. Okay, let's show you what the seatbelt seat is in. It is all the way back right now. Make sure this is tight. This one is, but double check that. And these are neat seatbelts because kids actually wear them. We just put one through this side, make sure it's straight, and then it goes over the shoulder. And we find kids use them because they're not so cumbersome to put on. So they are good. They're very good seatbelts. That's all we do. And then put in the center. And go across here and then you can tighten it and loosen it and, with all that there. So it makes it, you have a lot of play that you could do. Okay, first of all, sometimes these will get damaged during shipping. There's not much we can do. We've generally, when they are like this, we put them on the inside. But let's give you an overview of how to get before we install them. This is how both of these are the same. So if we come up here, I'm just going to install this one right there. Then it comes over back here. We install this one back here. We set it over there, and there's a hole for that. We're just going to get them installed. Same thing on this side. We did this here. This one's got a little also, so we put it on the inside. But a lot of that's covered. Like back here, look at this. This happens during shipping. It's covered. It's functionally in great shape. Now, let's look at these here. So we get a visual. This, like here, I grabbed this. Does this go here? No, it doesn't. So this one goes over here. This piece goes down here, and see, we're going to be lining it up through this hole here. I'm not yet installing anything. We're just kind of getting things figured out. Same thing with this one here. We're going to set this one over here, and then we're going, again, there's that hole right here. You can put your finger through it and see that, okay? Now, these three bars are not all created equal, and the reason, because the bottom bar on the back is used to install the little wrap. So let's just look at this here. If we look at these closely here, see this one here? Look, this has a hole in them. That is what's going to be used for this one here. So that means this one with the two holes go here. Okay? So we'll set this one here, kind of out of the way. And these two are identical, so that means we have one that goes here. Yep, this one goes here. So we're going to have one that will go here. And then there's one that goes here. So this just gives you an overview of how that works. We'll be showing you how to install everything here. And then this one is installed such that we have the hose on the top. We'll be able to twist it, because then this is installed like this here. And then we have those other brackets that will give it additional strength that goes from here to there. So that gives you an overview. So let's get started. So when we get started here, the key thing, we're going to set this back here, make sure it's out of the way. The key thing is we want to get everything started. We do not want to tighten down anything at all. And also, while we're talking about this, this piece here goes like this here. I forgot to put that on when we did the steering wheel. So I'll show you, just snaps right in. So we look at our bolts here. We got plenty of bolts, plenty of washers. So we'll get started here. Okay, what we've done here is we've put these together. We've not tightened it, but this really gives you a good showing of what you want to do. First of all, notice these have concave, so when we tighten them, you want to tighten it so it goes around the bolt there. And then we're going to twist it and do the same thing here. But if you look, we have the concave washers. We have one on the outside, one on the inside, because that way when we tighten it, the washer goes and holds the bar. So we talked about before, this is one of the center bars. We talked about over here, we have on this one here, we put the bolt through there because the threads are in the bar. We come down here, we have a bolt and a washer there, and then a nut and a washer. We come to the back here. Now, none of these are tightened yet. When you tighten them, you're going to want to line them up so the concave follows the bar, and so forth. So that's what we're going to want to do there. And then we're going also, so what we're going to do then over here. Now this plugs into this when we install this. If you've noticed, this is where that's going to go, and then this covers it because people tend to drive the go-karts in mud and dirt and stuff like that. So, but we're going to do it because we got all these installed here. We're going to start tightening them. And when you, these are 10s. 10 millimeters. I'll show you when you over here run this up. Okay, I'm now going to see we run that concave to that here. Same thing here. We're going to turn this here and do the same thing here. Okay, we're going to go on the other side. We're going to do this one here also. So this one here, we have that concave too. And then I'm going to do the other ones here and tighten them. Then I'm going to go through everything, tighten it, and then we'll come back and show you how to install that rear rack. We've tightened up all these bolts here. And that's, you have a really good view of how things are to be set up. Just come down, take a nice look. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to put on the back one. What we're going to do first is we're going in, put in here. You can let go now. It'll be a little sloppy. And we're going, okay, this here, We're going to run this on the inside of this here. We're going to plug this in. This is to the taillights and the blinkers. You see how that goes. We'll move this back here. It's a little, they have this a little too tight. So we're just going to move this up a little bit. And then it goes like that there. Okay. Then we have the other, don't push on it. That was my mistake there. Then we're going to install the other one here, and we'll come back and show it assembled. We've got the rear rack. A couple things. Let's come over here a little bit. We'll pick that up. We are missing a bolt here. You just go down to a local hardware store and get one. That doesn't happen too often, but if you're missing one, take one and match it up. This was the same size of shaft. The head was a 13 instead of a 10. The nut was 8. We took the nut. You were able to screw the nut right on. So if that happens, just go get one at a local hardware store. You can get them quicker. We want everything to be perfect, but there are times that something's missing and so forth. So now we got everything installed, nice and sturdy, snapped in. Now, we have to install the gas tank. Let me come close here. This is your oven on. You got on this way. Then it says off. It's kind of hard to see, but it goes off and on. So this is on, and this is a fuel filter, and then this is your gas line. Okay, so how this goes in, there is a trick. It's best to remove the bolts and the nuts. You're going to push with it there, you push all the way in, and then it slides so you can get it in and without scratching things. So now what we're going to do is we're going to put the rubber and the bolts in. Okay, now we got the last one. There we go. Well, now we're going to grab the nuts. We have four of them. We're going to put them on the bottom, and we'll tighten them up for you. And we'll come back and show you how to install the gas line. Okay, when you tighten these down, because you do have the rubber mount, you do want to tighten them snug, very snug. But don't over-tighten them to squeeze the rubber too much. Okay, we have that good. Now we're going to want to install the gas line. The gas line is this item here. This is the gas line from the gas tank. And that goes on right there. That's where that goes. You just squeeze this here. And we'll put that back on. That is a snug fit, and you do want it to be a snug fit. There you go. Now this fuel filter is an okay fuel filter. If you really want a really good fuel filter, remove that. Go down to a local parts store. You'll spend about $3 and get one of the really, really good ones. We do have we've done that ourselves. This is better than nothing, but they do make better fuel filters. When you do put gas in here, do not use ethanol. You want to put gas in here that's plain unleaded gas if you can get it. Premium is best. And make sure you're not taking out a gas can that's been sitting in the back of the garage or in the shed and it's so dirty, because all that's going to do is you're going to put gas in here and you're going to get dirt in the gas tank and so forth. So, okay. This gas cap is on extremely tight. When you remove it, all you have to do, it's just because it sat there for a little bit, if you take a little grease and grease the inside of these threads, it'll go in and out much easier, and then when you tighten it, it'll get to the top and seal it so gas does not spill out. because this is very tight. I don't have any grease right now, but that's what we're going to do with it, because it just, it's dry, that's all. It's been sitting for a while, and it's dry. Just put a little grease, silicone. Actually, grease is your best bet, so already it's a little easier to go on and off. So, well, before you start the engine, you're going to want to drain and change the engine oil. That's what we're going to do right now. It's a 17 millimeter. It's this bolt here. So we're going to get that. I got the drain bucket underneath there. It is good sometimes overnight to let it sit and drain, just because the oil is sometimes it's a thicker shipping oil. So it's not a bad thing to let it completely drain and so forth. We're going to let it sit and drain over the evening. Okay, so what we've done is we've drained the oil. We actually let it sit for a couple of hours. Everything gets out. So our next step is to put that back in. And when you put that back in, I'll just put it in with your fingers first. And then it's a number 17 to tighten it. So we'll run it up there and then grab our wrench and get that tightened up. It's very important that we get rid of the shipping oil before you run the unit, because the oil that comes in, it is a shipping oil. It is not a lubricant. We're going to be using 10W30 synthetic because we're in the fall time here. So we'll come underneath here, get it tight, not overly tight, but okay. Okay, this is where you put your oil in here. This is your dipstick and oil fill area. If you look at this here, you see this checkered pattern area? You want to fill the oil up to here at least. If it goes a little bit more, we're okay. But you do not want oil any less than that there, that top line of the checkered pattern. And also, little filter. We recommend 10W30. Prefer synthetic, doesn't matter what brand. So, and then we're just going to go a little bit at a little bit. Don't just assume that it's going to take a quart. So. Yeah, so we're a little higher than that. So what I'm going to then do, I'm just going to let it sit there for a little bit, make sure everything settles, and then I'll come back and make sure that we're at least to the top of that line. That's what's important. We come back, take a look at it, come up here close. Okay, so if we look at it, our oil level is a little bit above that, and that's okay. These don't take a lot of oil. You know, think about it, half a quart is not a lot of oil. So we filled it right up. It's a little higher than that, and that's okay. So you're looking at approximately half a quart of oil on this model here, and make sure you use synthetic. Okay, we get this question sometimes from a tech point of view. Hooked up my battery, turned on the key, and it's making a noise. What's causing it? That's your hazards lights on. Some it got bumped during shipping or when installing. There you go. We shut that off. So that's what's causing the noise. That's your hazards lights on. So to get rid of that, as you can see, this is out. When it's in, it's what, eighth of an inch. When it's out, roughly quarter of an inch. And make sure when you're not using the unit, you shut the key off, because this will drain your battery down. Okay, what we're going to do here is I put gas in here. What I want to point out too is, just look at that, that's off. This is on, and then gas will start to pour into there. If you always want, you don't have to do this, but if you want to verify that there's gas coming in there, always take a cup, and then you can pull this off and see that's a good flow of gas. I'm going to put that back on. You can take a fires or your finger and put it down there. Okay, I want to show you how to start the GK110 go-kart. Really simple. We put the gas in there. We showed you that. What we're going to do, this is your choke right here. This is your choke. We're going to lift that up. That is in the on position. Some of the carburetors will come with a metal one. Doesn't matter if it's metal or regular. We're going to lift up. That's how we lift up the choke. And it's a manual choke. Next thing is to make sure that the unit is in neutral. See this? That tells us we're in neutral. And now we're back in neutral. So, neutral, we turn over the key. Okay, you can also give us the gas. And after it runs a little bit, take out the choke. And that's how you start it up. Now over here, right here, is your idling screw. You want to pick up the idle, slow it down. That's what you do, is that's your screw to pick up on your idling or slow it down. I don't have a screwdriver here, so I'm going to use this. See? That picks it up. I'm going to put it back to where it is. So that's your idling screw right there. Let's talk about how to install our canvas top correctly. Okay, let's come up here close. Let me first I'll show you what the top side is. If you look at it, this is the top, this is the bottom. When you fold this over, you have a little crease here. That is the bottom. So this is the top. Also, we have to figure out which way is the correct way to install this. So we kind of lay this here. See this fits, let's see if that's the right way or if it fits better this way. No, this is much too big. And this is better. So it's going to go this way. So you just want to figure out which way it goes. Now, what we're going to start to do is we're going to start up this corner here. This is how you install it. You go around the underside like this, in the buckle, and we're going to line it up to the inside there, see if that's too tight, or if it is, we can loosen it. So we got that one installed. We're going to go to the opposite side and do the same thing. Again, this goes underneath, and then we're going to do the buckle. It looks like we can go a little tighter, so we're going to go a little tighter there. And we may have to loosen it a little bit, but then I'm going to go and do this one here, do the same thing. We're going to make it tight, you know, because then we can adjust it. I'm going to go make it nice. Okay, I'm not going to install the middle one yet. So then I'm going to come over here and do this here. I'm going to come over here and do this one here. There we go. That's how you install it. If you come around, look from the underside. It just helps to keeps the sun out. And then this is the top side. I'm going to just move this up a little bit more on this side here. There you go. That actually works a little better, nice and tight. See the same thing here. Oh, I didn't. We need to do this one here. I forgot this one. There we go. So that's how it looks. Little. Yeah, this is a lift gate. When you pay the extra $9.98, as you can see, it takes us from the tractor trailer, puts it on the lift gate, and then it can go up and down. And that's $9.98.